I greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, dear viewer, and hope that you are well. The Lord has kept you well and safe. I would like to welcome you in our 100 days prayer, 100 days series of prayer, and today being day 67. We would like to welcome you and thank you so much for joining us. You have been with us all through. You have been joining us each and every day. And if you are joining us for the first time, this is a series that we started March 27th when the World Church started praying for the pandemic that you are seeing around. We have been praying for the intervention of the Holy Spirit. And also we have been praying for our leaders and also for the infilling of the Holy Church in of the Holy Spirit in the world church so that we can be able to prepare well for the coming of Jesus Christ. And I would like to welcome you and to request you that may you be with us and even as we continue with this series. We pray that you will submit your prayers to the Lord and He will hear you, and also that you will have a different experience with the Lord and a new walk. We realize that speaking to Jesus or calling upon Jesus is the most urgent need that we have in our days today. And therefore, that's why we have been having this series and we have been going through this journey well, and we want to thank God today. I'd like to welcome you to our devotion or our sermonette before we get into the session of prayer. And today's topic is Reviled for the Truth. Reviled for the Truth. Remember, we have been speaking about the Beatitudes of Jesus Christ from the book of Matthew last week. The whole of last week we were speaking about them. And remember, this is in line with a moment for heart searching. Yes, a moment for heart searching, and we would like to welcome you. I would like to welcome you so that also you can be able to search your heart so that you ask whether you are in line or in tandem with the Holy Spirit or with God. And if you find yourself that you have fallen short or you have fallen away from the path, you come back to the crossroads and ask where you went wrong. And when you ask for forgiveness, our Lord and Savior is very willing to forgive you and to return you to the fold. Therefore, I would like to welcome you, and as we continue being blessed, shall we have a word of prayer so that we can lead the word and also we can hear from the Lord. Shall we pray? Our kind and loving Master, we thank you. We glorify thy name because great is thy faithfulness. Thank you for the 66 days that has passed since we started crying to you, O God. And we thank you for the miracles you have performed in our lives. And we also want to thank you for the miracles that you are yet to perform and the miracles you are performing even as we speak at this moment. And we ask you that may you be with us, continue hearing our prayers and continue doing your will in our lives. At this moment, we would like to invoke thy holy presence to abide with us so that Jehovah God, as we study your word, we will be able to understand it, and we will know that understand the truth, and this truth will set us free, and we will be drawn closer and closer to thee. Be with my dear viewer, and as I lead in this devotion, I pray for your spirit to be in me so that he can lead in me, and he can lead us, Jehovah God, to understand this word. It is in Christ Jesus we have prayed and given thanks. Amen. Our key verse today comes from the book of Matthew. We have been studying the book of Matthew for quite some time now. Matthew 5, where the Beatitudes are found. The book of Matthew 5. I would like to request you to open your scripture. To open your scripture and read with me. I'm using the New King James Version. You can use the version that you have. Matthew 5, verse 11 to 12. Through 12, the Bible says, "Blessed are you when they revile and persecute you, and say all kinds of evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for
For great is your reward in heaven, for so they persecute the prophets who were before you. I repeat this wonderful word again. Blessed are you when they revile and persecute you, and say all kinds of evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven, for so they persecuted the prophets who were before you.
These are the words of Jesus Christ. And remember, when he was speaking to the multitude, the disciples were with him. And Jesus being God, and he knew the beginning from the end, and he knew that his time on earth was limited, and there would come a time when he will ascend in heaven and leave the disciples behind. He wanted to encourage them, and he wanted to give them motivation to do his will, or to spread the gospel. And here comes a time that when they were keenly listening unto him, he spoke of these words, that blessed are you when they revile and persecute you. I don't know whether you have ever found yourself in such kind of a situation, when people are persecuting you, or people are there reviling against you because of something that you did not do. Maybe it is a false accusation that they have done, or they want you to carry that cross when you know that you did not do that. But it is painful, and it is not an easy task. But here Jesus is telling them something that is not unusual, something unusual, that blessed are you when they revile and persecute you and say all kinds of evil against you falsely for my sake. Blessed are those. You know, the disciples, he had seen, or he knew that in a little while, when he leave them, they will be persecuted. They will start speaking about his grace. They will start speaking about what he did. And they will start speaking about the gospel, or preaching the gospel of God. And people will be against them because they are preaching the good news. He knew that. And that's why he's telling them, be happy. Happy are you, blessed are you when they do that. Because he's saying that when they do that, then you should not mourn. People are dividing against you. But Jesus is telling them, when you see them dividing against you, do not mourn. But do what? Rejoice. Yeah? Rejoice and be exceedingly glad. It's not only glad, but exceedingly glad. Yeah? For great is your reward in heaven. He told them that you will be persecuted here down. You will be reviled against. There is a lot of things that they will be said against you. But you should be glad, because there is something which is better than what you will face kept for you. There is something better than that which is kept for you. And he says that even there, they did this, yeah? They did this, they persecuted the prophets who were before you. Let me say this. In every age, God's chosen messengers have been reviled and persecuted. Yet through their affliction, the knowledge of God has been spread abroad. Every disciple of Christ is to step into the lungs and carry forward the same work, knowing that its foes can do nothing against the truth, but for the truth. God means that the truth shall be brought to the front and become the subject of examination and discussion, even through the contempt placed upon it. The minds of the people must be agitated. Every controversy, every reproach, every effort to restrict liberty of conscience is God's means of awakening minds that otherwise might slumber. My brethren, let me say this, that God brings such kind of tribulations amongst us so that he can awaken us from the slumber. There will
come a time when you are spreading the truth, you will be reviled against. There will come a time when people will persecute you because of what you are saying. Remember the disciples of God. When Jesus left, they started preaching the good news about Jesus Christ. But people started rebuking them. People started saying that you are preaching of something which is not there. But they continued preaching the gospel. They continued fighting for the truth and saying this is the truth. Talking about who was Jesus, how he did marvelous things. And the moment the readership started persecuting them, even more people started believing in them. They started joining Christianity. My brethren, your persecution comes when your persecution come, or the time your persecution will come, when your reputation will be put or will be slandered, when your life, yeah, when your life will be put at the scale, I would like to request you that may you continue standing in the Lord. And even your life may be put in danger. Then Jesus' love and truth will shine the brightest. How you react, what you say, what you do when faced with these pressures will greatly determine the impact your faithfulness can have on those who seek to ruin your life. The disciples had a very great impact to the people who sook or who were persecuting them. Why? Because they behaved in a way that when they reviewed or when they thought amongst themselves, they say, these are the people of God. May God help you so that even if they will be persecuting you, you will stand on your ground and they will see that there is God who is living in you. A time is coming when you will be speaking the truth, but that truth will make you be persecuted. The last days are coming. We are nearing the close of the world's history. Be ready. Why not ask Jesus to help you to be faithful and loving today and every day, so that you are able to show that same love even under persecution, like the disciples. Today I would request you to pray to him so that he can make you a true Christian who will stand for Jesus through even if the heavens fall. Like the disciples, they say, we will fight for the truth. We will spread the gospel. We will say that Jesus died, that he came and he is the savior of the world. And even if you kill us, we will stand by that truth. And when you do that, his mission will be accomplished, and we will have accomplished the mission that he has given unto us. The mission of sending the truth to the whole world. The mission of preparing souls so that they can be ready for Jesus' second coming. Reviled for the truth. Reviled for the truth is the topic of today. And I hope that when that time comes, you will have the rattling. And when you have the rattling, that is the Holy Spirit in your heart, you will be able to stand like the disciples. You will be able to preach the gospel, and you will be able to be to bring many or to draw many to Christ. May the Lord bless you, and may the Lord keep you. As we continue with our series of 100 days of prayer, I pray that may God cover you under his wings. We are getting into a session of prayer, and I request you to humble yourself and submit yourself to the Lord. The prayers that you have in your hearts, just utter them. Yeah, utter them to Christ, and he is faithful. He will hear you. He will listen unto thee. And when he listens unto you, you will be smiling, and you will smile because you will have a testimony to tell to the world that indeed God loves you and God lives forever and ever. Shall we humble ourselves in prayer? And as we pray, let us remember our countries, let us remember our families, let us remember ourselves for a revival and reformation experience, and also let us remember the whole world church, so that God will revive us and will reform us to be like him. Shall we pray? Our loving Master in heaven, we are grateful and thankful for this day. We thank you for the word that has come from thy scriptures. Thank you for the hope that you gave unto us, O Jehovah God. And today we have looked at the hope when the people of the world will be persecuting your saints because of the truth. Jehovah God, we pray for that spirit
the spirit that was in the disciples, the spirit that enabled them to be courageous, to speak the truth. And even though the world would fall, they were ready to die for you, your sake. We pray for that spirit, O Jehovah God, so that he can lead us and he can help us to sojourn on as armies in your kingdom, so that Jehovah God, your coming will be hastened. Help us to let him in our hearts so that he can lead us, O Jehovah God, because when you, Jesus, lives in our hearts, when you come into our hearts, we usually do what is in accordance to thy will. And we can do mighty things when you are in us, O God. And that's why we invoke thy holy presence to abide with us and to live with us, so that we will be doing what is in accordance to thy will, O God. Even amidst this crisis that we have in this world, the pandemic that have shaken the world, O Jehovah God, we pray that you may help us to stand for you and to preach your gospel, even especially at this time when many souls and hearts are ready to listen to you. Jehovah God, may you make us ambassadors of peace, ambassadors of your word, so that Jehovah God, we will spread the gospel and many will believe and trust in you, and they will come back to thee, O God. At this moment, we pray that you may abide with us. Continue showering us with your blessing. Continue protecting us. Continue remembering the world church. Continue remembering our countries, our government, our medical practitioners, O Jehovah God, as they prepare themselves and as they fight this COVID-19, as they treat. Father, I pray that may you enable them, Father. May you, Father, heal those whom they treat, O Jehovah God, because the doctors treat, but you are the one who heals. Thank you because you have been with us in the past, and we believe that you will continue being with us and you continue guiding us in all our days, O Jehovah God. And at the end of it all, even after this pandemic and even after the history of this world, we will have an opportunity to thank you, to praise your name, and to celebrate together in heaven. Thank you because you are faithful and hearing. Thank you because of you are faithful and you have heard our prayers. For we have prayed this shortly, believing and trusting in that wonderful and precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Thank you, dear viewer. May you continue sharing this message, and may you continue joining us each and every day. May you be blessed, and even as you celebrate your Madaraka Day today in Kenya, I pray for God's presence in your midst. And as we start this new month of June and new half of the year, I pray that may God shower abundant blessings upon you. In Jesus' name, I pray for you. Thank you. Stay safe.